Captain Jean-Luc Picard, you lead the strongest ship of the Federation fleet. You speak for your people.
I have nothing to say to you. And I will resist you with my last ounce of strength.
Strength is irrelevant. Resistance is futile. We wish to improve ourselves. We will add your biological and technological distinctiveness to our own. Your culture will adapt to service ours.
Impossible. My culture is based on freedom and self-determination.
Freedom is irrelevant. Self-determination is irrelevant. You must comply.
We would rather die.
Death is irrelevant. Your archaic cultures are authority-driven. To facilitate our introduction into your societies, it has been decided that a human voice will speak for us in all communications. You have been chosen to be that voice.
Commander, they're leading us into the heart of our own defenses.
Yeah, well, so far they haven't had much of a reason to worry about our defenses.
Commander, if the Borg stay at warp 9.6, we'll be forced to discontinue pursuit and power down in less than 3 hours.
2 hours, 40 minutes, 3 seconds.
How long before the deflector's ready?
We're close. A few hours, maybe. I know I'll get it done in 2 somehow. But, Commander, I'm going to need serious power from the warp engines to make this weapon work. So far, we're using everything we've got just to keep up with them.
Sir, we've got to get that ship down to Impulse.
I'm leading an away team over there to get the captain back. We'll find a way to get them out of warp. Ensign Crusher, you continue to assist Mr. LaForge. Commander Shelby, you'll take the bridge and coordinate with Starfleet. Data, Worf, Doctor, you're with me.
Excuse me, sir, with my knowledge of the Borg.
Those are my orders, Commander.
Commander Riker, it is inappropriate for you to lead the away team. Until the return of Captain Picard, you are in command of the Enterprise. We're in a state of war, and your place is on the bridge.
Commander Shelby, you'll lead the away team. Make it so.